Halloween spectacular. The night is progressing spookily. Dogs are howling. Wolves as well.
Possibly coyotes.
We're going to open
the
up the phones.
Meowing.
We'll be opening up the phone line soon to get your personal tales on the air.
Yeah, we have phone lines now.
And yep. Yeah, that's
this
it.
Is going out live.
And this is...
You figure
this
out
is
the
live.
Phone number.
This is live. 8675309. And we'll be taking your calls.
Yes.
It's
a catchy
that poor,
number.
That
that's a catchy number.
That number.
Now, we've discussed Bigfoot. We discussed aliens. We discussed E.T., how it scarred us. Jurassic Park.
Yeah. Also scarred, but then was awesome.
Yes. We talked about moon bases.
Ernie, what's that? Oh, we got a call.
Ernie, what?
Well, let's go to the phones. All right, caller, you're on the air.
Hello. Hello, am I on the air?
Yeah, you're on the air. We're shooting the shit.
Shooting the shit. I can't believe it.
Yeah, please tell us your creepy story.
Shooting the shit.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, hey, how are you?
Oh, hi.
Hello. Hello?
Next caller.
All right. Oh, what? All right. Oh, we got another call here. All right. Got a caller on the air.
Hello?
Oh,
yeah, hi.
Yeah, hello.
What?
Want to hear about my experience?
Yeah, that's
yeah.
right, baby.
Yeah.
I'd love to hear your experience.
Oh, it was a dark night. It was out in the woods next to the city. And, wow, I just couldn't believe it, what was happening.
What happened?
All right. Thanks for calling. All right, we got another caller. Caller, you're on the air.
Hey, yo, what's up?
Hey, how are you? What's up?
People telling scary stories?
Yeah, that's right.
Let's hear it.
What do you got?
Yeah, okay. So there's one, you know, I drive a truck.
What kind of truck?
Oh, it's a big 18-wheeler.
Wow, you're a truck driver?
Yeah, that's right.
Let me ask you something. Do you participate in arm wrestling competitions?
What was that?
Do you participate in arm wrestling competitions?
Hey, anyway, I was driving down the 203.
Yeah, oh yeah.
I look up and I'm seeing these weird lights in the sky. And
what
so,
color?
White lights up in the sky. It's three of them. Wasn't a plane. I know every kind of plane there is.
Were they moving? Well, let me ask you a question. These three lights, were they moving around individually?
They were all together. This thing was going in a straight line out of nowhere. Yeah, this light suddenly made a 90 degree turn in the middle of the sky. I ain't never seen nothing like that before.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, you guys talk about aliens and, like, sticking prods up their asses,
Yeah, well, I mean, it would be nice. You know what? He's got a point. It would be nice. And thank you for your call. It would be nice to have...
I'm still here.
No. Goodbye. Thank you. Click. Ernie, there's something wrong with the switchboard.
Hey, can you hear me? And so...
Ernie.
I think that the aliens put something up my ass.
Ernie, you got to screen these
buttons. My ass. Yeah, I woke up.
No. The button's not working.
My ass.
The button isn't... I'm pressing it and nothing is happening.
That did it. I just unplugged the line.
Yeah, what I was going to say is it would be nice to be able to capture an alien and probe them.
Wow.
Right? Because they're always trying to probe us.
That.
Yeah. How do you like a taste of your own probe medicine?
Oh, this brings up an interesting thing, Dexter. Have you ever seen the footage of the guy who claimed... This was a story. He was walking in the woods.
Hold on. This was a story. It is no longer a story.
It is legend.
This is a story. He was walking in the woods. He sees a bizarre hexagonal black shape. Mm-hmm. And he's like, holy shit, that's a
I've
spaceship.
I've been there.
Out of nowhere, this alien comes out from behind the tree. He's walking his dog. This is the fucked up part. The dog runs to the alien. The guy takes the dog.
Control the dog?
Yeah, the alien takes the dog, rips the dog in half.
Oh, God, that's awful.
Yeah, and then the guy went insane, He went nuts. He beat the alien to death with a crowbar.
What?
Yeah, and then he took the body back home. He filmed it.
Wait, how did he...
Do you have this on YouTube?
This is
on YouTube.
I don't understand. Oh, I gotta see this. But I don't understand
right
is...
now, show me.
He doesn't have...
One, why is he walking his dog with a crowbar? Okay.
Okay. Maybe it wasn't a crowbar.
This alien is powerful enough to just rip a dog in half. I don't know. I'm assuming it's not like a Maltese or a
like
toy
a
poodle
Yorkie,
or something.
You could do that.
Yeah.
I believe it.
For whatever reason, when you're telling a story, I'm picturing this guy walking like a German Shepherd or a Mastiff.
I was thinking of a small dog.
He's holding it daintily by like a little, one of those like little leashes that, that they use in like dog shows.
Right.
But for some reason, I was picturing like this alien's ripping like a Newfoundland or a Mastiff in half.
Wow.
Okay. It has that power.
No.
And then he just pulls out a crowbar out of his ass, starts beating this alien to death. So this is after, so we're watching after he's already beaten the alien.
Yes.
Can you open it up?
So
just
dead panda? This is right after he beat... I don't think he had a crowbar. He beat the alien with his fists. And then,
I still say that how does an alien just sit there and get beaten to death by this crazed guy?
I don't know.
He is strong enough to rip a dog in half. What, did he grab him by the mouth and then rip him that way?
I think he took him by surprise or something.
Maybe.
But you can see here.
What am I looking at there? This guy's camera is shaky as shit.
So, that's the alien on the floor.
Uh-huh. That looks like a dead stuffed panda toy.
Is that just the head?
What am I looking at?
That's the head. He's wearing this black suit.
Oh, that is so fake. Oh, my God. It's like...
It's real.
What is he throwing up?
Yeah, I think he threw up there real quick.
Oh, that is so... Oh, my God. Look at how fake that is.
You don't know.
They have, like, a thing where it's, like, brains hanging out.
You've never seen
like,
an
in
alien.
A cracked skull. That looks like it's stuffed with straw.
This looks like the ones that I've seen.
But you
it
can
looks
see
like
the
a
eyes
deflated...
Are moving.
They're moving?
Yeah. The eyes are... Now he points a camera at the ship... Which is hovering.
Why does he have a video camera out with him like this while he's walking his
dog?
I don't know. This isn't like his iPhone or something. This is like on an actual videotape.
He said now he was experiencing like technical. That's the ship. It was hovering off the ground.
This is such horseshit. This is making me fucking angry. This is such horseshit. It's a cool story, and then when you see the video, it is completely ruined. You can't see shit!
What happens?
Alright, so... That's the supposedly...
What is that? That's the ship? You can't even tell!
It's hovering in the...
Oh, cool.
How small is that thing?
It was some tiny little pod.
How does
something.
That alien fit in that?
It's just a little probe.
Oh, yeah, but there's an alien there. So you're saying he had a separate probe ship with him? Like an Empire Strikes Back?
So that's not that small.
This was in the distance.
That alien was like at least 4 feet tall, though. There's no way
he's
fitting in
the
that
distance,
thing.
Though.
Well, there's more.
First of all, that the quality of that... Why is it that whenever you see in a video of this shit, the quality is so terrible? Everyone has a fucking HD camera on their phone.
I think this was taken a long time ago, and they never told anyone about it. So this is after he took the alien body home.
Okay.
And this is him just...
What, do you wrap it in tinfoil?
Yeah, and if you look, the eyes are blinking. The alien is like...
Oh, yeah. It's white?
Black.
No, and it's moving a little bit.
It looks so fake.
Yeah.
It looks so damn fake.
It's real, man.
No, it's real.
Totally
what is
real.
It wrapped in? Why is it wrapped in tinfoil?
I think he had one of like in his car, like a bit, you know,
those
when you
camping
go
things?
Camping.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Like right, to keep yourself warm,
insulates the heat.
Oh my God, the body looks so fucking. This is so fake.
His story is also...
So the alien wouldn't try and, like, communicate at all. It's still alive.
He bashed its head in.
Yeah, but it's still... Oh, my God. This is such bullshit.
What do you mean? Basically, he said what happened after this is...
He ate it.
No.
Alien surprise, anyone?
Most delicious cuisine. The rarest food.
He opened up a restaurant, It was called Extra Traviolis.
It was called... The review was, the taste is out of this world.
His story, basically, he was saying, like a day later, a bunch of government operatives showed up at his house.
Oh, sure.
That's right. They
took
did.
Everything.
Yeah, except this video.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
And, so yeah, just, you know, just some creepy footage.
It. I'm a believer.
I don't believe... I'm not saying that, like, something like this is not... isn't possible. I'm not saying that. I'm just saying that that is bullshit. That particular
right.
event. That video is false.
We have any other callers, Ernie?
What's that? Oh, yeah, okay. Caller, you're on the air.
Hey, man.
Hello.
Hey, I'm on Shooting the Shit Live?
Yeah.
Oh!
You got a scary story for us?
Oh, yeah, I do, man. This is my... encounter with Bigfoot.
This was a horrible mistake to go live and
this is my
so
you have to be quick, caller.
Where is this?
We got a
my cousin's bar.
Yo, where?
If you go to the Appalachian Mountains and you go to the south, right between the center on the in the east.
Can you tell us the experience? We got a hard break coming up in about 40 seconds.
Oh, okay. This is actually a secondhand encounter with Bigfoot.
Just tell
my
me.
Cousin's the one who saw it.
Great.
He told me about
and
it when he was drinking.
It's not in the Pacific Northwest, so it's probably
right,
it's totally in Bigfoot hotspots.
You have 30
like
seconds. 30 seconds.
And
I don't. You gotta ask my cousin. I told you it's secondhand. He told me about it. Kind of blacked out that night, but I know he told me something about. Seeing Bigfoot.
Okay, well, you know what?
Exactly.
Thank you for calling.
Yeah.
Well, you have 20 right, seconds. Let him go.
Thank
let him
just
you know,
that was it.
That was it?
Yeah. I already hung up.
You already cut
him.
The guy.
I already hung up.
Yeah.
All right, so we'll
that
be...
That was going nowhere fast. Well, he saw Bigfoot. So we got some guy saw aliens as a truck driver. We got a Bigfoot spot down in the south.
Mm-hmm. And so keep listening. We got some more creepy stuff coming up.
Let's
happy
take
Halloween.
A commercial break right here.
Right
thanks.
Here.
Oh, hello, everyone. I'm Walter Lovedyke, elderly erotic cinema star, director, and famed exhibitionist. You may remember me from elderly erotic cinema such as Kick the Can, After Dark, Erotic Expression, In the Depression, and Fun with Wrinkles 87. I'm here today... to promote an exciting new virility product designed for the experienced lover. The product is Straight and Narrow.
Straight and Narrow's patented anti-flaccidity formula will revitalize your withered bulbs by creating a spontaneous rejuvenative reaction stimulated by your own immune system, which, of course, is trying to protect you from Straight and Narrow's malicious chemical agents.
Straight and Narrow has given me the virility of a young 64-year-old and revitalized my relations. But don't just take it from me. Here are some of our satisfied customers.
Hey, man, I totally took some Straight and Narrow yesterday. I stole it from my grandpa's liquor cabinet. It's sweet, gets you so high. I love this shit.
I purchased this product on a Tuesday. The resulting erection was quite to my satisfaction.
I love Straight and Narrow. It's the only way I can have sex with my disgusting wife. She looks like a cow or a pig or some other kind of farm animal. I definitely couldn't get a big full erection without it.
We were able to use Straight and Narrow exactly for 2 minutes. Then my husband Bob died. I'm alone.
Call now and receive our complimentary corn now. Straight and Narrow, go out with a bang.